So I'll start off with a quote that I read in a book that I was given a few years ago. I was invited by the Singapore Management University to speak at an international women leadership conference. So at the end of the conference, I was given a book, and when I opened the first page, there was a beautiful quote that stayed with me, and I still remember it. It's one of my favorite ones, and it is about diversity, and I'll share it with you. So the quote is that men and women are two wings of humanity, and in order for the bird to ascend heavenwards, both wings need to beat in unison. So what basically this tells about that both men and women need to work together in various fields of life for their own benefit and for the benefit of the universe. So this is something that is now being reflected in organizations also. Some countries, some jurisdictions of the world, they achieved diversity somewhat earlier than we did, but I think we are heading in the right direction. So at ACCA, like Noor mentioned, that 46% of the members and 55% of the student population are females. Let me also share the stats for the ACCA Council that I am part of. I am one of the 36 council members, and the council is headed by Robert, who's the president. We have about 21 women out of 36. Wow. It wasn't by design. It just so happened that we have a lot of women there. And it's really interesting to see that women are making this space in not only at the board positions, but of course in the executive team, in the top leadership as well. The CEO of our organization, Helen Brand, she's a woman doing a remarkable job. And in the executive team also, we are maintaining a very healthy 50-50 ratio of men and women. So why diversity of gender and all sorts of diversity that I strongly, strongly believe in? Diversity in terms of where you come from, what your skill set is, your background, in terms of everything, diversity of race, religion, everything. All of this sort of brings so much value to organizations and to the world. Because the world is not homogenous. You are dealing with people from all backgrounds. So you obviously need to understand them. You need to sort of make decisions for them. You need to interact with them. You need to survive in this world. So that is extremely important. And there's a business case around that also. So like the top 50 companies in UK, when they sort of looked at their numbers, they saw that women where there was like a nice diversity in the boardroom, their bottom line results were very good. And why is it so? I'm not going to say that perhaps men are smarter than women or women are smarter than men. It is just that people bring their own different unique dimension in the workplace. They bring their unique value, their unique perspectives. So that is something that leads organizations towards growth. Many years ago, I decided to contest elections of one of the stock exchanges here, and I became the first female elected director on the board of that stock exchange. And initially, there was a lot of resistance. I was challenged. I was told that perhaps that's a space not for you. But when I worked with my colleagues there, I realized that it was not because I was a woman, or they were sort of, they didn't want anyone to come in there in their sort of safe space. It was because they were not used to working with women in the boardroom. And when they did, they found value in it. And later, some years, they invited me to join one of their other boards as well. So it's extremely important that when we are making decisions, we need to be inclusive, something that Noor mentioned earlier. We need to be mindful of everyone around us, which means all stakeholders. And which also means that we need to look beyond our own organizations. We need to see what's happening around us. And something other than diversity that I would like to share with you is the new role of leaders. Leaders are not bosses. Leaders are not who are just leading the organization or just who just have a C-suite designation, or they sort of have a fancy title, or they have a big room, they have the corner office. No, that's not what a leader is. Leadership models now have changed. So to stay relevant, and something that all of you would need in your lives in order to do well, is that you need to be transformational leaders. Now, what are transformational leaders? Transformational leaders are those, when they are really faced with challenges, they are put in a spot where they have to make very difficult decisions. They have to take their teams along in situations which could be very negative, with perhaps very limited resources. These could be in like people fighting in a battle, people working in an organization. So what these leaders do, they live by example and they make their teams included. So there's a very famous story of one of the British, this guy, I forget his name. He was he wanted to do an expedition to Antarctica. So when he was going with his crew, he sent out this ad saying that I want a team with me, and you're going to get very limited money for this expedition, and your coming back alive is also not guaranteed. So who's willing to come along with me? So he assembles the teams, they go on an expedition to Antarctica, and the ship breaks down. And they spend in a very cold weather with limited food, etc. They spend some time on that island, and how do they survive? Because they had to sort of wait for the change of weathers. So how do they survive? It was because the leader didn't give up. The leader, in this moment of adversity, the leader made sure that everybody was motivated, everybody had a task to do. They were playing sports, they were building boats, they were keeping themselves busy. It was because the leader was making sure that their minds are active, they are looking forward, and the leader was giving them a vision. So this is what leadership is about. You, all of you in your lives will face many, many challenges. You, hopefully not, but be ready for times where you may face a wall in front of you. Those are times when you do not give up. And you will not give up if you have your core values. And one of the core values is that you remain authentic, you remain true to yourself. So it's extremely important. There are so many things that you can achieve in life, but if you remain authentic to yourself, if you remain true to yourself, And Sajid was mentioning to something that I referred in the morning about happiness. So as a country, we should strive to be happy. We should, if everything is in order, of course, we will be happy. So that should be the ultimate objective, to make the environment around us really, really beneficial and fruitful for everyone. So you will be satisfied and happy if you're speaking truth, if you're content, if you're making good decisions, if you're taking care of all the stakeholders, you're concerned about the environment, you're taking care of yourself, you're taking care of your communities, your country, everything. So these are some of the core values you should practice, live with them, and you will be very successful. Thank you so much.